Airports are a marvel of modern design, with miles of pristine runway and massive climate control terminals, often in really remote locations. Airports have become a central part of cities, with many population centers planned around them. So, how did airports evolve to become such important places? Hi, I'm Advay, and tonight I'm talking about how airports and air travel as a whole have evolved since we invented the airplane just over 100 years ago. Let's start from the very beginning. When the Wright brothers made their fateful flight back in 1903, aircraft were flimsy vehicles built using simple frames. They could barely carry any weight apart from the pilot. Since this meant that aircraft could not hold passengers, there was no need for airports as we know them today. Instead, they were aerodromes, where people could come and admire the modern miracle of flight. These aerodromes were fairly basic, with a large grassy strip for craft to take off and land, and a few hangars to park and repair planes. But soon, something drastic happened. Something changed the state of air travel forever. World War I. When war broke out in 1914, countries quickly realized that airborne forces could be used for reconnaissance missions as well as bombing runs. This led to a dramatic increase in the demand for aircraft and led to the construction of large hubs and command centers for the new fleets of aircrafts that the countries now wielded. The war's use of aircraft also acted as a catalyst for aircraft technology. This improved technology, when coupled with military airfields that had been constructed, finally allowed for the commercialization of air technology, with cargo and passenger flights becoming possible. The first buildings dedicated to air passenger travel were what we refer to as terminals, were built in France and Britain in the early 1920s. Soon enough, air traffic control towers with multiple radar dishes in order to triangulate the locations of nearby planes sprouted near the airports. Oh, by the way, have you noticed how airport entrances are all usually curved? Well, this is because Tempelhof Airport in Berlin originally had a curved entrance, not for a functional reason, but rather to avoid a nearby cemetery. Anyway, as air traffic steadily grew, airports became surrounded by large, smooth, paved paths to support the larger and heavier planes. Airports began to be built in ways that would allow for later expansion as well. As technology continued to progress, air travel's cost steadily decreased. This led to an increase in demand for large terminals and better routes between the airports and the aircraft. To solve these problems, busy airports constructed massive terminals with unique orientations, allowing for more efficient air travel. While European airports were usually large and centered on inland terminals, America followed a very, very different model, the marine terminal. Throughout the eastern seaboard of the United States, airports were designed to accommodate both conventional land planes and seaplanes that took advantage of the fact that many major American cities were built around the coastline. After World War II, new airports were built in what was called a connection or transport design, with planes parked on the tarmac and passengers walking out to them. As larger planes parked further away from the terminal, shuttles began transporting the passengers to the planes. As jet planes were introduced, which required even more space, this became even more essential. To reduce the distance between the buildings and the passengers and the planes, airports started gaining thin, long, reaching wings that the planes could dock at and passengers could wait in, with a large central area for major functions. Delhi's biggest terminal, Terminal 3, is a great example of this design. In the 1970s and 1980s, however, things like terror started becoming a concern for airport designers. Bottlenecks and secure spaces were included to increase security. A lot of the extensive checks that we associate with airports were introduced in this era. Finally, in the 21st century, architects have been looking to make airports more pleasant and attractive. This has led to the inclusion of numerous shops, restaurants, and spaces within the airport itself. Even structurally, the airports have become more aesthetically pleasing, with large open spaces, art installations, and plentiful natural lighting. As air traffic has become more and more accessible, airports will have to continue to adapt and grow. What do you think will be the next big thing in airport design? Let us know in the comments down below. Hey, we hope you found this video fun/informative/useful. If you want more cool content, click up here to watch a video randomly chosen by YouTube's algorithm. If you want to subscribe, click up here.
We'll see you in the next video, but until then, good night, sleep tight, and don't let the C-Mix little areas bite.